Hello, my friends. Welcome to Yoga with Megan. I'm so glad you're here. I'm excited to be back on my own, no boot. My ankle's getting better. And I'm looking forward to doing yoga with you guys. So let's start by taking our special and kind hands, the hand that has something special, something we're really good at doing or we're learning to do, something that's kind, something we do for others. And let's put those two hands together and bring them to our heart. And when we see that I have something special and kind and you have something special and kind, we greet each other by saying, Namaste. Namaste, my friends. Let's sit up nice and tall, making sure that our space is safe for us to do our yoga together today. And let's take a big breath in through our noses. And out. Right? When we do that, our bellies get bigger and smaller. Let's practice with the ball one more time. Big breath in. And big breath out. Amazing job, my friends. All right. We've greeted each other. We've gotten our bodies ready. And now we get to go on our yoga adventure together. So, my adventure today is called Polar Bear, Polar Bear, What Do You Hear? That's my story. And it's by my favorite author, Eric Carle. He wrote the last two books we're reading together. We read together. Polar Bear, What Do You Hear? Look at all those cool colors. What do you hear, Polar Bear? Polar Bear, Polar Bear, what do you hear? There he is. So our first pose is our Polar Bear pose. Now, to do our Polar Bear pose, we're gonna come on all fours like this. And we're gonna be like a Polar Bear just waking up, right? And he's gonna stretch. So we're gonna come on all fours. And we're gonna bring one arm out and the other arm out. And we're gonna bring our chin to the ground or our forehead to the ground. There's my forehead. There's my chin. Big breath in. And out. And in. And out. Good job. Stretching like a polar bear. Amazing. Let's see what the polar bear heard. Polar bear, what do you hear? I hear a lion roaring in my ear. Oh my goodness, there's that lion. So my friends, we're going to come on our knees and we're going to put our hands on our knees and we're going to take a big breath in through our noses. And when we breathe out, we're gonna stick our tongues way out and lean forward and roar. But the roar is coming from down here, not from up here. So it's not a, it's a. We're breathing with our breath. So we take a big breath in and we breathe like a lion. Nice lion's breath. Let's try to get a big breath in and out. And one more time, big breath in. And out. Amazing job, my friends. Let's see what that lion heard. Lion, lion, what do you hear? I hear a hippo bellowing in my ear. There it is. All right, my friends. Our hippopotamus pose is going to look like that's where we come on all fours again, and we're going to bend down like a hippo. So we're going to bring our mouth to the ground. Maybe we get a little bite to eat or a little sip of water. We're going to come down like this and up. We breathe in on the way down and out on the way up. And one more time, big breath in and out. Beautiful. Hippopotamus, hippopotamus, what do you hear?
I hear a flamingo fluting in my ear. Here it is, it's standing on one leg. It almost looks like a number four. There it is. Our pink flamingo standing on one leg. So this time we may want to grab something to look at that isn't going to move. And we're going to stand just like the flamingo. So we're going to look at the ball and we're going to have one foot up on the floor. And then your other foot can be like a kickstand like this, like we do sometimes with our tree pose. You're gonna lean forward like the flamingo did. And then you can try to lift that foot up maybe. Big breath in and out and in and out. For my friends who are maybe even a little bit older, you can lean forward. Lift your leg up and maybe cross it like the figure four. Big breath in and out and in and out and all the way up you come. Let's try it one more time with our other leg. I'm actually going to face you guys to do this. So we're going to stand on one leg, the leg we had up before. Stand on the ground. You're looking at something on the ground that isn't moving, right? And then first you start with your foot on the ground, and then we lift it up, and then maybe we can cross it over. A big breath in and out and in and out. Beautiful flamingos, excellent job. All right, let's see, what is the flamingo here? Flamingo, flamingo, what do you hear? I hear a zebra braying in my ear. Bray, bray. It's kicking up its legs. So my friends, we're gonna come back to our mat. And we're gonna come into our downward dog position, like this. And we're gonna lift up one leg, and then we're gonna lift up the other. Now, because of my injury here, I can't do it quickly, but if you wanted to, you could try to do it fast. You could run, you can maybe even hop, and then switch and do it on the other side. I'm not gonna do that. Hop, and then switch and do it on the other side. Big breath in. Big breath out. Beautiful job. And down you come. Zebra, zebra, what do you hear? Ooh, what is that zebra gonna hear? Let's see. I hear a boa constrictor hissing in my ear. Look at how long this boa constrictor is. It goes all the way around. Yes. All right, friends. So we're going to be the boa constrictor hissing in his ear. So we're going to come on the ground all the way down to our bellies. We're going to take a big breath in all the way up like a nice, tall, long boa constrictor. And then we're going to hiss down to the ground. Ready? Let's try it again. Big breath in. Nice and tall. And then hiss. Down to the ground. Let's try one more. Big breath in. And hiss. Boa constrictor, who are you gonna hear? Boa constrictor, who do you hear? here? I hear an elephant trumpeting my ear. Here's the elephant. He's got a big ear and a long trunk. Big ear, long trunk. All right, so we're gonna remember that when we do our pose right now, because we are gonna make the big ear, which is right here, and the long trunk, which is our leg. And we're going to lift up the trunk. Big breath in and out. Good job, let's put it back down and let's switch. Here's the other elephant ear. Here's that long trunk again. And we're gonna lift it up. Big breath in and out. Now, this elephant can be kind of silly. So this time, let's let it grab some water. I'm gonna point my toes. It's drinking the water. And then I'm gonna lift it up and it starts to spray everybody. Excellent. And let's try the other side, ready? Grab some water and lift it up and spray. Awesome. Fabulous. Let's see who else is here. Elephant, elephant, who do you hear? I hear a leopard snarling in my ear. Ooh, look at that leopard. With those teeth. What sound does the leopard make? It's snarling. I don't know. Kind of like a grrr sound, probably. All right, so we're gonna do some cat poses because the leopard is really a big cat. So we're gonna put our hands on the floor, our knees on the floor, and we're gonna take a big breath and look up. And then be that leopard and go, look at your belly. Big breath in, look up. Big breath out. And one more time, big breath in and out. Excellent job. Leopard, leopard, what do you hear? I hear a peacock yelping in my ear. Look at how gorgeous this peacock is with all these beautiful feathers. Oh my gosh, it's beautiful, isn't it? Yes. Okay, friends, ready? You might want something to look at again, because this one's a balancing pose. We're balancing on 2 feet though. We're gonna come into our squat and we're looking at something. And we're gonna bring our big, beautiful feathers behind us. Big breath in and out and in and out. One more time, big breath in and out. Beautiful. Sit back down. Let's see. Peacock, peacock, what do you hear? I hear a walrus bellowing in my ear. There's that walrus on its fins. Its slippers, I mean, its feet. It's got the tusks. It just kind of waddles back side to side. So, get your best walrus voice. And on your mats, we're going to put our hands sideways. And we're gonna come down just like we did for the boa constrictor pose, only now our hands are sideways and we can go back and forth like this, or maybe we can even lift up our
hands. And you can sound like a walrus if you want to. Or. Big breath in. And out. And in. And out. And sit back down.
Let's see who the walrus hears. Walrus, walrus, what do you hear? I hear a zookeeper whistling in my ear. The zookeeper just brought the walrus some food. All right, friends.
So, the zookeeper was whistling. So we're gonna practice our whistling breath. And actually, I will come a little closer.
All right, so to do the whistling breath, we want to make sure that we are blowing cold breath onto our hands. So if we take a big breath in, and we go like this, feel that on your hands. That's a warm breath. But if we take a big breath in, and we go, that's gonna be a cold breath. Now when you do that, maybe you even make a noise with your breath. Look at your hand and try it. If you don't make a noise, it's okay, but I want you to feel that cool breath. Good job. Let's see, who does the zookeeper say? Or hear? Zookeeper, zookeeper, what do you hear? I hear children growling like a polar bear, roaring like a lion, snorting like a hippopotamus, fluting like a flamingo, braying like a zebra, hissing like a boa constrictor, trumpeting like an elephant, gnarling like a leopard, yelping like a peacock, and bellowing like a walrus. That's what I hear. All right, friends, we are gonna do all the poses one more time together.
All right, so first was the polar bear. So we're gonna come on our mats again, put our hands on the ground, and we're gonna walk our hands out, and we can roar, roar like the polar bear. Then came the lion. So we're gonna sit on our knees, put our hands on our knees, we're gonna take a big breath in, and we're gonna roar like the lion. Good job. Then put your hands back on the floor and we're going to snort like the hippopotamus. Ready? Big breath in, big breath out. Getting ourselves ready, we come down, big breath in, out, and in, and out, and in, and one more time, and back, up. Good job. Then we have fluting like a flamingo, making sure we're looking at something. We come on one leg, we bring the other leg down or up. Big breath in and out. Good job. And then let's switch on the floor, up a little or across. Big breath in. Oh, I wasn't looking at something. And out. Good job. Then we have that zebra pose. We're going to come into our downward dog again. And remember, you can go quick or you can hop and hop or you can just walk in place. Big breath in. And out. Excellent. Then we're going to come all the way down like a snake. Big breath in. And out. And in. And out. Good job. Come all the way back up. And we're going to sit like the elephant. Here's the ear. Here's the trunk. We're going to lift it up and spray everybody. Great. And let's switch. Lift it up and spray everybody. Awesome job. And then we've got that gnarly leopard. We come on all fours again. We look up, big breath in. We gnarl as we look down. Hands in. And one more time, breathing out. Awesome. And then we have our beautiful peacock. So we're going to balance. And come up, big breath in. And out. And in. And out. And then we have our last one, the walrus. So we're going to come back down, but our hands are sideways. And we can go back and forth. Or lift up our hands, big breath in. And out. Amazing. The end. For all the colors. Whew, that was a lot of work at the end there to see all those children dressed like those beautiful animals. It's time to bring our bodies down to rest a little bit. So, here's my magic dust brush filled with all the dust. And it's very, very busy, just like we are very, very busy right now. And then when I hold it still, all the dust settles down. Nice and calm. But if I move it again, the dust moves too. So those are like our thoughts in our mind. Very busy, and we want it to all settle down. Again, you can pretend to have some on your hands, and you can rub it in. I'm gonna rub some in. There it is, right on my forehead, making me nice and calm. You can rub it all over your body if you want to. Find a comfy place to sit. First, turn off lights that are on in your house to make the space quiet and cozy. Yes. And then you're just gonna lie down for a few minutes. Resting your bodies. So you're going to lie all the way down, right? And we are going to either have our hands by our sides or on our bellies. And we're going to take a big breath in. And we're going to let it out. And in. And out. You can pretend that there's a shavasana there. I wonder what yours looks like. It can be any color. And it comes with one of these magic yoga dust brushes. And as you're lying here, you can pretend that there's a magic yoga dust fairy with the magic yoga dust brush rubbing some on your forehead, rubbing some on your shoulders, putting a little dust on your arms. Hands, putting some more dust on each of your fingers, starting with a thumb. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10 fingers. Then the yoga dust fairy puts a little bit of yoga dust on your legs, and your ankles, and your feet, and each one of your toes, starting with the little one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, from your head to your toes. Magic evidence is working. And on your next big breath in, you can bring your arms up over your head. And a big breath out, hug your knees. A big breath in, we come to sit up. And now that our bodies are nice and calm and relaxed, and the magic yoga dust has worked, we put our hands on our hearts, and we think of someone we love very, very much who we think could use a hug. So you can close your eyes, and you can think of someone. It can be a person or an animal. One person, one animal, lots of people, lots of animals. They can be living or not. You get to decide. If you're with someone, you can tell them who it is. They can be in the room with you. They could be very, very, very far away. Right? And we take a big breath in. And we send them a magic hug. Breathing out. Let's try that again. Hands on our hearts. Close your eyes, picture the faces of the people you love that you want to send your hugs to or your animals. Take a big breath in and send them a hug. Beautiful. Let's bring those special kind hands back together at our heart center. We respect each other by having kind hearts. Can you guys say kind hearts? Let's say it together, kind hearts. Beautiful. Hands to your mouth. Can you say kind words? We always want to remember to use our kind words. Let's say it together, kind words. Fantastic. Bring your hands to your forehead. Let's remember to have kind thoughts. Let's say it together, kind thoughts. And then we can say namaste because we see the special and goodness about each other. Namaste, my friends. As you go about the day today, I wonder what you're going to hear. And close your eyes and listen like when we did Shavasana, I could hear the birds outside my window chirping. Take a minute and listen. Kind of fun. Maybe you could even draw a picture of what you heard. You could take a walk and listen and then go home and draw a picture. Have a great day, everybody. I hope to see you all again very soon. Enjoy the nice weather we're having. It's starting to get warmer out, where I am anyway, in Massachusetts. And we'll see you soon. Namaste, everyone. Bye-bye.